There's nothing more frustrating than losing a crop that we've already harvested. Today we're going to talk with Tim Schnockenberg, regional agronomist for University of Missouri Extension. Tim, what are some of the ways that we can lose a crop that we've already harvested?
Tell you what, a lot of times we don't realize that we could potentially lose as much as half of our crop from the standing crop to feeding. We want to minimize those losses as much as possible. Storage is probably one of the biggest ones. Outdoor storage is challenging if you don't have the barn to put it in. One of the best ways to deal with that is to use a net wrap to maintain the integrity of that bale, to get it up off the ground so it won't rot, because that's where most of the losses occur in storage outdoors.
How about as far as if we are storing outdoors, how should we look at our hills and our orientation north and south, east and west? How about that?
Well, high elevation is a good place to put it in order for water to run away. And you can put it on gravel, you can put it on anything that keeps the water from pooling around it. You also want to get good light exposure in order for it to dry out. So keep it away from being under trees where it's not going to have too much shading, where you're not going to have the sunlight to dry those bales out.
So as far as the north, south, or east, west, you got an opinion there?
I think north, south is probably the best way in order to get full exposure of the sun on that bale so it dries out.
Thank you, Tim. With a Making Hay Minute, I'm Brian Setzer. Hope you enjoyed this episode of Making Hay Minute. Please check out some of these other videos or find us at makinghay.com.